Hello, friends. Welcome back to English Classes Online. My name is Benjamin. Today's video is on Junior School Certificate Examination, English Past Questions and Answers, 2018 and 2019, Lexis and Structure, with specific focus on vocabulary development. We are going to answer the questions on vocabulary development for the year 2018 and 2019, respectively. If you are new to this channel, kindly subscribe to the channel by clicking on the subscribe button below. Click on the bell icon as well, so that whenever a new video is uploaded on the channel, you will be notified instantly. Let's dive into the lesson right away. Now, objective questions at a glance. We have been going through all these various sections of the exam, but today I want us to go straight to Lagos State Basic Education Certificate Examination of 2018, English Studies Objective Test. Under Lexis and Structure, we are going to answer questions on vocabulary development. Now, the instruction is as follows. From the options lettered A to D, choose the best word to fill each of the numbered gaps. Science and technology have assisted the world in many ways through wonderful dash. And so that is 11. We have to find a word that will fill in this gap. And this is the vocabulary of science and technology. So we are looking at vocabulary from the point of view of the words and terminologies associated with a particular field of human activity. All right? There are words that are associated with science and technology. And that is what this passage is all about. And so the various gaps need to be filled with the appropriate words. So let's now look for the options. Science and technology have assisted the world in many ways through wonderful dash. A, inventions. Yes, that's the correct option. B, interventions. No. C, intentions. No. D, creations, no. Now, you may have heard about scientific inventions, all right? For example, Michael Faraday invented what? Thomas Edison invented what? So these two simple questions will show you, you know, that these are inventions, you know? Scientists down the ages have made inventions, all right? So the appropriate word is invention. Okay, so let's now go ahead. Virtually every nook and cranny of the world has felt the dash of science and technology. A, impact, that is I-M-P-A-R-T. No, this is not the correct option because you can impart knowledge to people. But when you are talking about impact, it is with CT. The meaning is effect. The world has felt the effect of science and technology, the impact. Option B, feelings. No. Option C, impact. Yes. I-M-P-A-C-T. Impact. Option D, actions, no. In the hospital, the dash thermometer can be used to measure the dash of the body. Well, you may have heard about clinical thermometer, all right? So let's look at the options in number 13. A, medical, no. B, mercury, no. C, technical, no. D, clinical, yes. clinical thermometer. Again, you see that we are not only dealing with vocabulary, we're also dealing with collocation. Collocation is a grammatical concept which refers to a group of words that are usually used together, a group of two or more words that usually go together. So clinical thermometer. You cannot talk of technical thermometer, mercury thermometer, medical thermometer, no. But you must have heard about clinical thermometer. And what is it used for? It's used to measure the dash of the body. Of course, thermometer is used to measure the temperature. So you can see it in number 14, option A. Temperature is correct. Option B, warmth, no. Option C, coldness, no. Option D, hotness, no. The answer is option A, temperature, all right? Now let's take the last question. Doctors use a dash to listen to the heartbeats. Doctors use stethoscope. Stethoscope is that instrument they hang on their neck. They use it to listen to the sound of someone's heartbeat, all right? So that is stethoscope. So option A, stethoscope, no. Option B, stethoscope, no. Option C, stethoscope, yes. Option D, microscope, no. All right? So that's exactly the way it is, okay? So now we are going to the next one, which is 2019. All right. Now the instruction is the same. Here again, we are looking at Lagos State Basic Education Certificate Examination of 2019, English Studies Objective Test, Lexis and Structure. The instruction is as follows. From the options lettered A to D, choose the best word to fill each of the following gaps. You see, this has to do with vocabulary, all right? The words associated with a particular discipline or field of activity. So let's look at the questions here. Mr. Badmus was very sick. So he visited the hospital close to his residence. So you can see this passage is dealing with the language of health or the language of medical treatment, if you like. He was dash of typhoid. Let's look at the options. Number 11, option A, diagnosed, yes. That's the correct option. He was diagnosed of typhoid. You know, when you are diagnosed, it means that the doctor checks to find out what actually you are suffering from. That is diagnosed, you know, finding out from the symptoms, you have headache, you have this, you have that. From there, the doctor will be able to arrive at what exactly is wrong with you. So option A is the correct option, and that is diagnosed. Option B, diagnosed, no. Option C, examined, no. Option D, treated, no. Now, let's proceed to the next question. He must have dashed it from eating unhygienically prepared food. He must have dashed it from eating unhygienically prepared food. So let's look at number 12. Option A is contacted, no. You see, a lot of people mistake this. You contacted has to do with contact, when you get in contact with somebody. But in terms of disease or sickness, you contract it. Contract, not contact. So option B is correct. Contracted. He must have contracted it from eating unhygienically prepared food. Option C, collected, no. Option D, received, no. Now let's go ahead. The doctor dash antibiotics for him. All right. So number 13, option A, described, no. Option B, proposed, no. Option C, prescribed, yes. The doctor prescribes certain drugs or certain treatment. The word for it is prescribed. When the doctor writes out and says, okay, you are suffering from typhoid, so he will write down the antibiotics you need to take. That is prescription. The doctor prescribed. Option D, ascribed, no. You can ascribe something to somebody, but when it has to do with verifying what is wrong with somebody health-wise, the word is prescribed. Now let's move ahead. He was then advised to adhere strictly to the dash. Okay, what should he adhere to after giving him the prescription? Option A, system, no. B, method, no. C, drugs, no. D, dosage, yes. Yes. You know, when you are given drugs, you are told to take 2 tablets in the morning, 2 tablets in the evening, and so on. So that is dosage, all right? And so he was then advised to adhere strictly to the dosage. So the correct option is dosage. Now let's go to the last question. He was wished a quick dash. So let's look at 15. Option A, recovery, yes. You wish somebody quick recovery. When someone is sick, you wish him quick recovery. That's the word. Option B, discovery, no. Option C, healing, no. Option D, treatment, no. So you can see that vocabulary development has to do with mastering the words that are appropriate when discussing a particular field of activity. If you are talking about health, there are certain words that are relevant when talking about health. And when you are discussing sports, there are certain words that you can use to talk about sports. If you are talking about computer, there are certain words that belong to computer, all right? So that is what we mean by vocabulary development. And it is also called register, all right? So that is exactly how it has been. And this is where we draw the curtain on today's lesson. I hope you learned all that there is to learn from this lesson. I hope you actually enjoyed today's video. If you did, make sure you like the video and share it with your friends and relations. If you have not subscribed to the channel, this is the appropriate time for you to hit the subscribe button below and make sure you click on the bell icon as well, so that whenever a new video is uploaded on this channel, you will be notified instantly. If you have any questions, comments, or suggestions, please leave them in the comment section below. I want to say a big thank you to all of you for being part of today's episode. You can find time to browse through this channel and you'll find many related videos that will be very useful to you in your determination to achieve proficiency in English. Now, I look forward to seeing you in the next lesson. Bye-bye for now and remain blessed. Many thanks for watching today's video. A big thank you to all of you out there for being part of today's episode. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, kindly subscribe to this channel. Subscribe now as a way of giving us support. For notification about new videos, click on the bell icon. You will find the bell icon. Click on it so that whenever a new video is uploaded, you will be instantly notified. If you have actually enjoyed the video, like and share the video with your friends and relatives. This If you have any comments, leave your comments below. Any questions, any suggestions, we would gladly receive them and respond promptly and positively to them. See you in the next video. I look forward to always seeing you.